I am Rafael Stern, a PhD student at the Weizmann Institute with Professor Danya Kir. Using large dry land areas to build photovoltaic fields can have opposite effects on the climate, and it is important to understand them. Besides the carbon emissions reduction by replacing the fossil fuel burning in the thermoelectric power plants, the photovoltaic fields can also change the albedo and the sensible heat flux at the surface. Our study was conducted at the hyper-arid Arava Desert in Israel, close to the border with Jordan. We used a mobile eco-variance flux station and radiation sensors, and also thermal and multispectral cameras carried by a drone. We installed all the instrumentation in a PV field and in the outside desert for about 1 week in each season of the year. We observed that the albedo in the PV field was 0.1 smaller than in the desert, which means that about 10% more of the incoming solar radiation is absorbed by the surface, creating a positive radiative forcing. We also observed that the sensible heat flux over the PV field was higher than in the desert, which was more evident during the summer, when during the peak hours of the day, it reached about 400 watt per meter square over the PV field compared to 200 in the desert. The air temperature was lower in the PV field during all the seasons of the year, especially in the autumn, when it was about 2.5 degrees lower. If we consider the carbon emission by kilowatt hour produced by fossil fuel combustion and the production of kilowatt hour per meter square of our PV field, we can then calculate the annual carbon emission avoidance by this PV field. The negative radiative forcing created by this carbon emission avoidance takes about 1 year to start to compensate the positive radiative forcing created by the albedo effect and to start to create some real benefit for the climate. The photosynthesis rate of a pine forest plantation in the desert close to this PV field is much lower than the carbon emission avoidance. We can conclude that the albedo warming is efficiently compensated by the carbon emission avoidance by the PV field, and that the higher sensible heat flux over the PV field is efficiently dissipating this heat, but could create changes in the regional atmospheric circulation, and that in dry lands, PV fields are more efficient than trees to reduce the carbon in the atmosphere.